Besides these very simple checks to see if one value is equal to another or not equal to another, we also have three different operators that allow us to do a little bit more complicated check. We're going to first take a look at between. We can make use of between to check to see if a value is between one number and another. Easiest if we just take a look at a quick example. So once again, I want you to notice that we've got Delhi, Shanghai, and Sao Paulo. They've got areas of about 2,240, 4,000, and 3,000. So let's try to select all of the different cities with an area between 2,000 and 4,000. If we do so, I would expect to see results of Delhi and Sao Paulo. So I'm going to update the where statement right here, and I'm going to change it to area between 2,000 and 4,000. That is how we make use of between. We put down the value that we want to take a look at, then between the lower bound and the upper bound. So now we're going to see all the different cities that have an area between 2,000 and 4,000. So I'm going to run that, and there we go. So we get Delhi, Sao Paulo. We can increase that upper bound to say 5,000, and now we are going to also include Shanghai inside of our result set as well. So with between, we just need to remember between one number and another number. We could also make use of in and not in. These check to see if a value is present in a list that you and I are going to provide. So the list that we're going to provide is going to be some kind of hard-coded list of values for right now. So let's try to find the list of cities. How about all the names and areas where the name is equal to, how about Delhi or Shanghai? To do so, we could write out where name in, and then we'll put a list inside of here using a set of parentheses. Inside this list, I'm going to put in a string with single quotes of Delhi, and then right after it, another string of Shanghai. Now we're saying give us all the cities where the name is listed inside this list, either Delhi or Shanghai. If we run that, we then get just Delhi and Shanghai. We can also do the exact opposite of that, where we say give us all the different cities that are not present in this list. So we could update this query right here to say where the name is not in Delhi or Shanghai. And so that will give us every city that doesn't have a name of Delhi or Shanghai, and we end up with Tokyo and Sao Paulo. Now we are not restricted to just using strings with this in and not in operator. We can also use numbers inside this list as well. So for example, we could update the property right here, the column name from name to area, and then we could say that we want to get all the cities that have an area of not 82,203 and 3043. So I'll update the values inside the list to 3043 and 8223. Now I would expect to see all the cities besides Tokyo and Sao Paulo. And sure enough, if I run that, I get Delhi and Shanghai. Okay, so that's some of the different comparison math operators that we have access to. The last thing I want to show you is that we can make use of multiple operators inside of one where statement. So for example, we could try to find all the cities that have an area not in 3043 and 8223. And then right after that, we could put in another check. So we could say and then put in another comparison right over here. So we could say, how about all the cities that have a name equal to Delhi? So now we are doing a compound check. We are going to first find all the cities that have an area not listed in that list and the ones that have a name of Delhi. So that we're going to make sure that we only find cities that satisfy both of these statements right now. So if I run that, we see just Delhi. Besides and, we can also use or. So I could put in or right here. Now we're going to say find all the cities that have an area not listed in that list or a name of Delhi. So if I run that, now we'll see both Delhi and Shanghai. We're seeing Delhi because we have a name equal to Delhi, and its area is not contained inside that list. And we're seeing Shanghai because it's got an area that is not contained inside that list. We can chain on as many and or statements to this where clause as we want. So we could say format this really quickly just to give myself a little bit more space, and then put in another one here and say or a name of Tokyo. on that. And now we get Tokyo added to the list as well. These where statements we put together are frequently going to end up being kind of complicated if we are trying to find some very specific data. So we could end up putting in many different little checks inside of here and join them all together with either ands or ors. Okay, so this looks pretty good. Let's take a look at a quick exercise in the next video.